EvaWigs, it's your girl Key. Welcome back to my channel. Now, before we get into it, be sure to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss anything else. Now, let's hop right into it. Now, you guys, I know you're seeing this beautiful hair on me, and it is from Eva. I will leave a link down to their website down in my description bar. But I am wearing their Indian Remy wig, and it is in a 22-inch in a 150 density. It is the color natural black. I got 6 inches of parting space, I believe, and my lace is a medium brown color, and it's already pre-plucked. So that is the beauty of this wig. Now, when I first received the wig, it came in a block Eva box. The box was black and it just said Eva on the front. And when I opened it up, my wig was smack dab in the middle. I'm probably gonna have to cut a portion of showing you guys that wig because they do put your shipping address pasted on the front of the plastic of the wig. So, you know, that could be a pro and a con. But when I opened it up, there was also a booklet that had information on the hair, how to treat it, how to wash it, anything you would like to do with that wig. It is in the instructions on how to care for the wig. So that's really great that they added that, along with a wig cap and a comb. And I'm actually using the wig cap because I didn't have any wig caps. So thumbs up to Eva for adding those wig caps in because I actually did not have one. So, of course, when I looked at the construction of the wig, it had major parting space, you guys, like a lot of parting space. It actually had an adjustable band in the back and a clip, and then in the front there were combs as well to add to your hair. You can take them out if you'd like. I did not take mine out. I actually kept mine in because I didn't feel like I had to take them out at the moment because they weren't far up. That's the one thing I hate about some wigs, that the wigs put the combs far up and it's rubbing against the side of your hair. This is actually not far up and it's not rubbing against the side of my hair, which is why I did not remove them. Now, the wig is already pre-plucked, you guys, so I did not have to do any work to the wig besides I opened my part up a little bit because of the fact that I like space in my part, if that makes sense. Some people like their part pretty tight and all they do is like comb it down. I like space in my parts, so that's just a personal preference. If you don't like spacing in your parts, then this wig, legit, you won't have to do anything to it. When I say you don't have to do anything to it, the sides already pre-plucked, the middle is already pre-plucked, like you do not have to pluck it if you do not want to. Now, there was lace in the back, but I did cut it because I have no intention on pulling it up or doing anything like that. But I did cut the lace all around, and there is major parting space, which I am super happy about. Now, yes, granted, there are tracks in this wig, so you can't part it down the middle and give yourself 2 pigtails or anything like that. But there is major parting space in the front where you can give yourself a whole bunch of styles and you can enjoy the way the wig is going to work for you. Now, this hair is very silky. It is a silky texture. It's not a yaki texture. So that's a little bit like, it can go either way. Like, I feel like this wig is a wig you could do the blunt Chinese Nicki Minaj bangs because of how straight the wig is and how silky the texture is. You could definitely get away with doing blunt bang and, you know, doing the pull up top knot in the middle and doing that whole style. I wanted to crimp it, but I feel like it won't hold because of how straight the hair is. The hair is so straight and it's so beautiful and so soft that I feel like trying to nappy it up will not work to give it like a texture. I don't feel like it will work because I like to do like, ever since I got my kinky straight hair, I want to do like some texture in the hair. So I was thinking about doing small crimps in the hair to kind of give it that kinky texture. But I feel like this hair is so silky and so smooth that I don't think I could give it that kinky straight look. So I just left it alone and did this gorgeous straight look. Now, I am not getting any shedding with this hair, and I'm glad because since it's a 150 density, it is a natural density. And you know, when your hair is really long, like this hair is 22 inches, is really long on me. When hair is really long like this, it looks thinner. So I'm glad I got this kind of natural texture. I feel like if I cut it shorter, it would look thicker, you know what I'm saying? But so far I'm liking the length of the hair, I'm liking the density of the hair, and I love that it already came pre-plucked. That is a major A plus for people who want to just get a wig and plop it on their head, style it, and go about their day. They don't want to have to bleach the knots, and pluck the hair and put in all that extra effort into a wig, I feel like this is a wig you can legit put on your head, got to be glued down, cut the lace, and, you know, enjoy your night on the town. This is definitely a wig you don't have to put a whole bunch of effort into. And everyone needs a wig like that. A wig you can legit toss in your head and take out the trash. Like, something like that, I feel, is something every woman needs, because 9 times out of 10, we don't have our hair done. So you want to have something on your head that will make you look cute, affordable, and really, really nice. So I definitely want you guys to check out EvaWigs. This wig is very beautiful. I really like the way it turned out, and I love that it is just a simple hairstyle. I can pop it on my head and go. It's not much effort you have to put in this wig, so I definitely want you guys to check out the site. I will leave it down below in the description bar, and I will check you guys in my next video.